Good morning all. Today we will talk to Ms. Anu. She is owner and founder of Anu Solutions in Dubai. Her company helps people to establish their business and company formation, registration in Dubai along with corporate solutions. Welcome you, Anu, on this topic related to company registrations and all related to everything licensing and procedures which we can talk about.
Hi Gaurav, thank you for your introduction. Thank you for this brief introduction, and let's see, we will start our live video.
Yes.
And please, you can ask me any questions, what's in your mind.
Yeah, definitely. So Anu, my first question is, what points a person or investor should consider while opening a business in Dubai?
Actually, there are basically 5 points which a person should keep it in mind. Like it depends the jurisdiction, first jurisdiction, which area he is willing to open a company, because in Dubai the company formation registration process is divided by the areas. Mm-hmm. See, so I'll tell you like there are two type of jurisdiction here which is more popular. One is mainland and another one is free zone. So this one we will discuss next step. And okay, afterward there are other points like do we need an office, and what about the residency visas, how many visas is need, and the business activity choose, and the cost. So all these factors decide setting up a company in UAE here.
Okay, mainly so the restriction, business activity, office requirements, residential visa and costs involved is basically depend on these 5 factors.
Yes, correct.
Okay, so my next question is, what do you mean by jurisdiction in Dubai? Like if a person going to start a company, then what would be considered as a jurisdiction in Dubai?
See, as I told you before, there are two type of jurisdiction here which is more popular. One is mainland and another one is free zone. So what happens in mainland, in local market companies, the UAE national who is a holding a UAE passport, local person must be a owner of the company. It means he must hold 51% stake in the company, and the balance 49% is held by the foreign expats, means the investor. So okay, the ratio is 51% and 49%. So this is in the case of local market companies. But on the other side, if the client choose free zone company, there he can take the 100% ownership of a company. So in that scenario, he don't need a local partner. And suppose you are want to open a company and you want to totally under your control. You don't want any other person in your company, right? Like you want to be sole single shareholder. So you can choose free zone where you will be holding 100% ownership in your company.
Like suppose I am going to start a company in free zone and I am not in UAE national, then I can hold 100% of my equity or something related to that?
Yes, that's possible. So what happens here, the first step is to register your company. So when you register a company, like UAE is not restrict to any nationality, first of all, let me tell you. Any nationality can open a company here, can set up their business here. It's not restricted by nationality or anything. So any person who is willing to invest here or who wants to start his own business, he can do it here. And first he has to register the company. Once he registers a company, then he have to apply the residency here. Okay, in order to open a bank account. Yes. Yes, please.
Sorry to interrupt you. Like suppose any person of any origin, any citizenship can start a company. But is there any restriction or any kind of activity which is prohibited in Dubai?
Yes, there are certain activities which is only reserved for the local people. I mean, which is reserved only the UAE national only. There are like especially oil and petroleum dealing like this. And some medical equipment, pharmacies, and some other items are there. There is a list actually, which is reserved basically for the UAE people, and like real estate. But still, they make the law lenient nowadays, and you can have a partnership also in these activities as well. And so yes, most of the things, I mean, you can choose any activity nowadays, especially in free zone, you can take, because they remove all the restrictions. They want business come to their country. So that's why they're removing all the restrictions and letting the other people to come and invest. Yes.
And even in the time of lockdown, when Dubai's industry is hit by mostly of it, they are might be convenient to have the foreign investment through these kind of things.
Yes. They are accepting. In fact, UAE has been locked down also like other countries. Corona has affected worldwide. So it was also under lockdown for 2-3 months. But we recovered very fast. And now, thank God, we are back to business. And in fact, even during that time, we accept the applications remotely without visiting the regional authority and government departments. They were open and through doing work from home like other countries.
That's so perfect. Even we are still on the work from home activity kind of a thing. So my third question would be, what type of activity allowed in UAE economy? Like any kind of allowed?
In Dubai economy, actually there are more than 2000 business activities. So it's depends upon the investor, the person who wants to open a business here. So what's in his mind? I mean, what is requirement? Suppose you want to open a trading activities, trading like trading in garments, clothes and shoes, apparels, accessories, furniture. So this one like trading of products, you know. And suppose somebody interested in service license. Service means he wants something in website, IT design and all, which is like professional services, which is not trading. So it depends what is the investor's requirement, what he is willing to do.
Okay. That's perfect. So my next question is going to be like, what about office requirements? So if a other kind of citizenship person is going to start their office in UAE, so is it necessary to take office?
Yes. In order to take a license, you must have an office here. And there are options. You can choose a virtual office. Or like initially when you're starting up, you don't want to be like a big, big spacious office. You can take a virtual flexi desk office where you will be assigned a sharing desk or sharing co-work space. So it will reduce your cost and at the same time you will have a physical, you know, presence here in UAE. So it's like a must. It's as per the law, you must need a office here.
That's perfect, because mainly software engineering or software kind of people who are going to start, they would do the business through virtual office route as well.
Yes, because when the government issue license, in the license you will see, I will show you one sample license also later on. You will see the company name, next is the office address. So if there is no office address, so it doesn't make sense, you know, like how the company is established here. So there must be an office here, and the office is provided by the free zone authority itself. And if it's a mainland company, you can choose any location up to your requirement.
Okay. So is there any residential visa issues or any kind of concept related to residency visa?
Yeah, I'll tell you about this one. Actually, why we need residency visa, I'll tell you first. See, in order to open a bank account, nowadays, bank must ask that you have a residency visa here. Suppose you open a company, you get your legal documents like certificate of incorporation, MOA, memorandum, article, you know, same like in India and other countries we have.
Similar
we got
concept.
All the legal documents. Yes, same. Mm-hmm. So we got all the legal documents. Now, second step, you want to open a bank account. Because without bank account, nobody can do business, right?
Definitely.
In order to open a bank account, you must take a residency visa here. And it's like the government issue a sticker on your passport. You got a 3 years validity visa. Along with you get one ID, which we called Emirates ID. And this is also valid for 3 years. So with these documents, you can easily get everything. You can open your bank account. You can take your property here, or you can take any internet connection. I mean, it's like same like in India, we have, you know, national IDs. You can say like passport, voter ID, other card. It's same like this. But in UAE, we have only one ID. Yeah, we call it Emirates ID. Yeah.
Perfect. How much it would cost to a person if a person is going to start and going to find a standard license package kind of a thing?
See, it's all, as I told you, it depends upon his requirement, what he's looking forward. If he just need a license only, it means he just need a legal document, his presence there. And in that case, he can open his license, he can take his legal documents as low as in 3000 USD. But if you want a bank account as well, so bank account means you must have a residency visa, right? Okay. So that residency visa cost, it's additional. So this one, like license plus office plus residency visa plus bank account opening, all the service fees comes around 8 to 10,000 USD somewhere. So it's like this. But nowadays, due to Corona, free zones are offering some promotional offers and all are going on. So we can help you in that in no time. Yeah.
So we can say like the cost depends on jurisdiction, business activity, office requirements, residential visa, and everything.
Yes, perfectly. You are right now. Yeah.
So these are the combos related to it much of a.
Yes, correct. Yes.
Thank you, Anu, for giving us the time related to this topic. And we will definitely provide a series of topics related to different industry segments. And I have heard that there is also a concept of freelancer visa as well over there. Freelancers set up their business.
Yes, people can do freelancer visa also. Yes. Yes. So we will discuss on our next video in that. And maybe we'll discuss on the activities wise. So it will be helpful. Yeah.
Definitely. Thank you, Anu, for recording this session.
Thank you. Thank you very much.